and just like I was happy with the inclusion of Fog of War finally in my tutorial series, I'm even more happy now because I was able to make the fog place faster, load faster, and make the fog different so that once it's explored, it stays unexplored, but if you're not currently viewing it, it darkens again, and it bases it on distance instead of time. So this video will start from scratch. You do not have to watch the previous one. You can disregard that if you want. I would use this one instead, and I'll show you how to implement it into your RTS game if you have been following along with my tutorials. If you haven't and are just here for the Fog of War, just go by this, and I'll explain where you need to change different code to fit your game. Now, we can start off with Object Hero, which you don't need to worry about. It just simply moves around the map for display purposes, but it should have a depth of 0, and this is where all your characters will be. If you've been following my tutorials, this would be the equivalent of Attack Spot Enemy, where all of the enemies attack with their AI. So that's how the fog, how the fog will view it, because as long as any object is there, it will lighten up the area, and you can see better. So now we have object fog, place fog, and draw rectangle. I'll start with draw rectangle because it's the easiest and the quickest. It does not need a sprite. Its depth, as you can see, is -2. It needs to be the lowest number, because in Gamemaker, the lower the depth, the higher or on top of the screen it is. Negative comes towards you, positive goes away from you if your screen was 3D. Think of it like that on a grid system. So in the draw event, we have two events, both of which are underneath the draw tab. First one is underneath settings, set the color. Set the color to black. And then draw a rectangle and do x1 is 0, y1 is 0, room underscore width is x2, and y2 is room underscore height. So what this does is it works for any map. It'll just draw a filled black rectangle, filled should be filled, a filled black rectangle over the entire room, and because it's the highest object so far, place underscore fog, which I'll be going over, is above it, but all other objects should be below this. So take the highest object and make this one higher, or lower technically, if you're looking at it on a number line. Now we have place underscore fog. This is the highest one in your game. It should be the lowest number or the highest negative number. I know that sounds weird, but it should be the highest absolute value but a negative number in your depth of all your objects. Now in reality it only has two events. I'll delete these and to explain what I mean later. It has a create event and a step event. In the create event we set x is equal to room underscore width times 0.5. This sets it in the center. Then we have y equals room underscore height times 0.5. This puts it in the very center of the room. So that's why we do that. Then we have current x is equal to 0 and current y is equal to 0. Think of that as a 0 and 0 on the map, the top left-hand corner, and remember that. Global.roomStar equals 0. That's just a global variable to let other objects know when all of the fog is placed. And then we have instance underscore create in parentheses x comma y comma draw underscore rectangle. This just creates the draw rectangle object, so that way you only need to put place fog in your room, and it'll take care of everything else for you. In the step event, we have this piece of code here, instance underscore create, and then in parentheses, for the x coordinate, we're going to do current x, comma, current y, which is the x and y coordinate, respectively. And then we have comma object underscore fog, which is our fog, whatever you decide to name it. So at the current x and y, we create the object fog, or a fog object. Then, as soon as we create it, current x plus equals 32. So we're going to move it 32 pixels to the right because that's how big our fog is. So now it creates one, and it creates one next to it, and then it'll create one next to it, and next to it, next to it, all the way to the right until we get to the beyond to the end of the room at the right. And how do we know when we get to the end of the room on the right? If current x is greater than room underscore width. So if that's true, there's no reason to keep adding objects. We already filled the room with y's. Current x is now equal to 0, and current y plus equals 32, which means we're now going under it again, and we're going to fill it up. Think of it like a Word document, word wrapping, how it goes all the way to the right and then goes to the next line, and it'll fill up the entire thing. That's how we're doing it here. And finally, if current y is greater than room underscore height, which means we filled everything and now we're outside the room on the y-axis, global.roomStart equals 1. So now we let the other objects know in a global form that the room is done loading, all the fog is placed. Now in object fog, what we have is, in the create event, we set a variable maximum is equal to 5. Oh, I forgot to mention something. In place underscore fog, take the step event, duplicate it, and set it as right-click, duplicate, step, begin step, then right-click, duplicate, step, end step. So now it does it 3 times as fast. Then we're going to go over our fog itself. In the create event, of course, it has maximum equals 5, then step. If global.roomStart equals 1, it will only shade itself if all of the fog in the room is loaded, and that's when we start seeing itself. Image underscore alpha is equal to distance underscore 2 underscore object. Now this function just finds the distance of a number in pixels if you were to beeline it to that object. And then of course we use the instance underscore nearest function, which I've used in a lot of my tutorials, for x comma y comma object underscore hero. You can watch my previous tutorials if you really want to figure out how to use this function. So instance underscore nearest object hero divided by 64. 64 is basically your range, and it creates a ratio, and we multiply that by 1. So if it's 128, it's too far away for it to really be in range, so we multiply it by 1. However, if it's 32, then it's halfway directly to in range. So now, instead of 1, image alpha is 0.5, which means it's half transparent, or half invisible. Now, if distance to object, we use the exact same function again, instance underscore nearest, the same object and everything, is less than or equal to 64, maximum equals 0.75. So now, when it's not close, the maximum it can be is 0.75, which is 3/4 of the way full, or 1/4 invisible, which adds a nice dark hint, but when we get closer, it all works out. And then we have, if image underscore alpha is greater than maximum, image underscore alpha equals maximum, so we never go over that maximum. And then we have a with function, with, and in parentheses, draw underscore rectangle, instance underscore destroy, and then with place underscore fog, instance underscore destroy. You can see it there. That way, only after the room starts will they destroy, so you don't have to worry about them anymore. So how you actually go about putting this in your room, after your map is made and your character is placed, just go ahead and put in a place fog object. It'll go right there. We're going to go ahead and play. I'm just going to move them around, but as you can see, the loading is actually just a sprite, and the black is actually just a rectangle, and it's covering everything loading, and that loaded pretty fast, even though this is a small map. As we go around, you'll see that there's a little, almost light, and it does have a kind of effect, because over here is darker than right here, and here is the lightest spot. And as we move away, it starts to get dark again, but it's not completely black. If there was terrain, it would look only a little bit. Now, one way to change how dark it is, instead of maximum equals 0.75, you can set it to 0.5. 0.5 is another one that works really well. I just didn't choose to do it here, so that's totally up to you. And that's Fog of War based on distance. I do advise to disregard the previous one because the fog on this works a little bit better. It's a little bit more seamless, and it loads faster. So you can do any combination of the two videos. I'm going to leave them both up because of that. Feel free to comment, of course, if you have any suggestions. And of course, if you have a suggestion for my RTS series, please comment that below. And thanks for watching.